Tell us something about today's masterclass.
Well, I think what Neville is doing is an amazing exercise, and all of us are trying to do our best to support an endeavor that is so amazingly good, and that could truly change the atmospherics of art and culture in India.
What is it that we can look forward from this masterclass today? What are you going to be speaking on?
Whatever you ask me, I will answer. And I think everybody's life story is the beginning of someone else's learning. And I guess this is what all masterclasses are about. I hope you'll have fun.
Be sure.
So a certain kind of cinema, politics to some extent, but we can see the fragmentation there more than anywhere else. So technically, it is still, after many years, India is still living very much in the realm of its ideation. And we've been now nine months of every day trying to give people what they don't want and persuading them to believe that it's something that they should think about wanting. Not an easy exercise even in a small country like Greece, let alone India. Numbers are a very strange thing. You can twist numbers anywhere. I've, in my mind, sitting outside, I started to twist a few numbers. We've actually had nearly 49,000 footfalls from September, nearly 6,500 registered people who are willing to give a rupee or two, and for showing them black and white Romanian films and obtuse Polish films and films on subjects which nothing in India nurtures or supports or takes forward. It's a foundation. And festivals in our country, we have four or five major film festivals. On average, footfalls are 8,000 to 12,000. Someone that will help me make my film, take my film forward, make me understand something deeper about the aesthetics of cinema, etc., etc., is an essential component which somewhere along the line, when you do a film festival 365 days a year, is going to suffer. So one is in the middle of the next transformation of this model. We've learned quite a few things. We've had some of the finest minds, brave minds, from Adu to Shyam to Kritish to Potash to Anupam to a whole. We've started with cinema. We will now start adding the fine arts. We will also start bringing in the architects and philosophers and open up that unity which we've been trying to represent for a couple of decades. It does take the stuffing out of you each day. And if you start adding the numbers on the net, about 450 people come to Osianama. There's about 1,000 or so people who very superficially go through Facebook, and there's another 1,000 or so people in other media who every day engage. So technically you're engaging with about 3,000 people a day. Now, whether that engagement is of meaning or whether it is a kind of deceit, that there is some kind of contact which is leading to something meaningful, is another part of the issue. But I think that is going through every part of this country. And I've traveled every little corner, nooking corner. You can go to our galleries, you will see barely 10, 20 people a day. You can go to the great architectural sites apart from the Ajantas and the Tajs, and you will barely see 50 to 100 a day. So, and let alone the other areas where drama, poetry, theatre, dance, classical. classical dance, a whole host of other philosophical debates, where you would barely, if you do it on a daily basis, get 20 to 30 people, and most of them will be speaking the same language, already converted to that cause, looking to bring someone else to join their cause. Ironically, after so many years, very nascent, all of us must do what we can. So we take forward with great joy, with great commitment. And today's masterclass brings together a man who has really tackled life with full, diverse passion, great intellect, a compassion of the soul which has searched from the days of the idealistic poet to the day of ability as editor of some of the leading newspapers and magazines and journals of our country, to then taking on a political responsibility, even though it be, which was one of the questions when he asked with Shiv Sena. There are many reasons, and many of them will be very interesting to hear. Then again going into the television media, then going into the world of cinema, all the time finding new outlets for his creativity, creating new institutions, not being content with just the inner voice being expressed, but also building the material framework which one recognizes is essential for the dissemination of that voice in a meaningful way. And he's probably at a stage, and for me, one of the key reasons is that deep sense of love for the fragile, the gentle, the vulnerable, the helpless, most best epitomized by the stray dog. In human activity, human togetherness, we expect from the human a bit more than what is delivered, and slowly, inch by inch, day by day, we realize that unqualified love is more important because it allows us to love. And that's why the world is more and more going towards loving animals, loving nature, loving a dialogue with something which is alive but doesn't bring the harshness and the negativity and the pettiness of a soul which by and large most human interaction is somehow bringing to the fore. But all that we will talk about more and more in our masterclass. So without much ado, may I invite Mr. Pritesh Nandi onto the stage for the webinar.